You are not an ordinary person. We are the outshining of God's glory. Don't let any circumstance have enough power to bother you. The Father has nowhere to stay than inside you and cannot express himself unless through your body. So your body becomes his body. That is why the Bible says we are the body of Christ. Shout this. Say, I'm a doer of the word.
I'm a world shaker.
I live by the word.
I'm
born by the word.
We
are here to produce heaven on this earth. I produce heaven on earth. Zadiva Kasi. For whatsoever is born of God overcomes the world. And this is the victory. That's why I say, don't give up. Hey! Moko sei ki paravuka du seti baha. Zagu. Rebege de Bezia. Vege. Yakusa tifaroski parakataya. Ah, I feel like turning water into one.
Pastor Brent. Worth hearing.
Acts chapter 2 verse 34 says, for David is not ascended into the heavens, but he said himself, the Lord said unto my Lord, sit thou on my right hand, until I make thy foes thy footstool. Verse 36, therefore let all the house of Israel know assuredly that God has made this that same Jesus whom ye have crucified both Lord and Christ. Is that not powerful? Is that powerful? Now therefore, verse what? 36. Is this 36? 36. Therefore, let all the house of Israel know assuredly, and today the house of the Lord is going to know this truth.
Hallelujah.
That God has made that same Jesus whom you have crucified both Lord and Christ. So God made him Lord. Is that true? So before God made him Lord, there was no one who was Lord. Go to Psalm 110. Cause in the Bahasa. Are you ready for some truth?
Yes, sir.
It is time to rule. It is time to control. It's time to exercise authority. Is that not powerful? Psalm 110 from verse 1 to 3. So what I want you to understand, we'll come back here, is that God, it says, the scripture says that God has made him, the one who was crucified, the Jesus who was crucified, God has made him both what? Lord and Christ. He's been made Lord and he's been made Christ. But before he was crucified to be made Lord, no one was made Lord. No one could have been made Lord. Did you hear what I just said? No one was made Lord. Now he says, the Lord said unto my Lord, Psalm 110 verse 1, says, sit thou at my right hand until I make thy enemies thy footstool. This was David speaking. This was a psalm of David. And he was speaking prophetically concerning the lordship of Jesus. Amen. So he says that the Lord said unto my Lord, sit thou at my right hand until I do what? I make your enemies your footstool. Sit at my right hand. So he was speaking concerning the resurrection and the ascension of Jesus. Amen. Amen. He was speaking prophetically. This had not yet happened. But David, being a prophet, knew that Jesus was going to be made Lord. And the Lordship of God was going to be given to one man. That was Jesus. And knowing that the Lordship of God had not yet been established, spoke prophetically and said, the Lord said unto my Lord. Now when you check the translation, please, Jehovah said unto Adonai. But when you take it from the Old Testament and bring it into the New Testament, because Jesus made mention of this scripture in the Gospel of Mark, and then Peter makes mention of this scripture again where we just read in Acts chapter 2. What he was actually implying was that the Father said unto the Lord Jesus, the Father said unto the Lord Jesus, sit at my right hand. Sit where? At my right hand. Nobody was qualified to sit at the right hand because nobody had been raised from the dead. And because no one was qualified to sit at the right hand of the Father, nobody could exercise the Lordship of God. Have you heard what I just said? You hear what I just said? Because nobody. So he says, the Lord said unto my Lord, sit thou at my right hand. He says, until I make your enemies your footstool. Sit at my right hand. So the Father was speaking to the Son Jesus to sit at the right hand. But that was a prophetic revelation in Psalm 110 because Jesus had not yet come. Yes, sir. You hear what I just said? Yes, sir. So David, being a prophet, foresaw. And that was what Peter was referring to. Peter the apostle in Acts chapter 2, where we just read, was referring to when he mentioned that in Acts chapter 2. You can start reading from any verse, from 30, 20. You catch something there. And we'll read it. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. So the Lordship of Jesus had not yet been established. Amen.
Amen.
Have you heard what I just said right now?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So the devil could not be made Lord because he could not sit at the right hand of the Father. Amen.
Amen.
And the first man, Adam, was also not Lord. So I said that Adam had what we call dominion, not lordship. Did I say that?
Yes,
why? Because Adam was given dominion over a particular territory. And it was defined. The fishes of the sea, the birds of the air, and all that had been created. So Adam could not be made Lord. Have you heard what I just said?
Yes,
so Adam was not Lord. What am I trying to tell you? I'm trying to tell you how superior you are to Adam. I'm going to tell you how superior Christ is to Adam, the first Adam, and how superior you are by your association with the Lord Jesus to the first man, Adam. Have you heard what I just said right now? So it's very important we understand that truth. Jesus exercised lordship when he was on this earth before his death because the Spirit of the Lord came within him. So he cast out devils. He healed the sick and did all those things he did in lordship because of the Spirit of the Lord that had come upon him. But even though the Spirit of the Lord had come upon him and was exercising lordship to some extent, say to some extent, because he had the backing of the heavenlies behind him as the anointed person in his day. And he said, the Spirit of the Lord is upon me. That Spirit of the Lord was within him. And because of that, he could exercise lordship. That is why he said, if I, by the finger of God, do cast out demons, then the kingdom of God has come. If I, by the kingdom of God, if I, by the Spirit of God, do cast out demons. That's what he said. Is that what he said? Is that what he said? Why? Because of the Spirit of the Lord. But even though the Spirit of the Lord was in him, and was on him according to what he said, and he has anointed him to set the captives free because of the Spirit of the Lord that was upon him, he had not been made Lord. When he was walking, he had one authority, the heavenly authority with which he was dealing with things on the earth. Amen.
Amen.
But don't forget that the devil, Satan, had authority too. Satan had taken the authority that was given to Adam. Amen.
Amen.
And Satan had the authority of hell, spiritual authority, to rule over hell and to rule over the earth. So Jesus could not be made Lord. Have you heard what I just said?
Yes, sir.
He could not be what? Be made Lord. See, the Lordship of the church.
The Lordship of the church.
Have you understood what I just said right now?
Yes, sir. We understand.
Is that powerful? So it's very important we understand. So it says, the Lord said unto my Lord, sit thou at my right hand until I make your enemies thy footstool. Go to verse 2. Then he says, the Lord shall send the rod of thy strength out of Zion. Then he says, rule thou in the midst of thy enemies. Oh, shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
It says, the Lord shall send the rod of thy strength out of Zion. Zion is the church. So it meant that David foresaw the lordship of Jesus and the rulership of Jesus through his church. David foresaw prophetically. We'll go to Acts chapter 2, don't worry. And you see there, amen.
Amen.
But it says, the Lord shall send the rod of thy strength out of Zion. Rule thou in the midst of thy enemies. So we are ruling on this earth in the midst of the enemies of Christ and the church.
Hallelujah.
It says, the Lord shall send the rod of thy strength. So that authority that Jesus has, the scepter of that authority is what he calls the rod of thy strength. Remember, Moses had a rod. Is that true? So the rod of thy strength that he's talking about is the scepter of authority of Jesus, or the lordship of Jesus that had been granted the church. That was what he was speaking prophetically in verse 2. To rule. So the rulership of Christ is done by the church on this earth. The lordship of Christ is perpetuated by the church or through the church on this earth. Who is the church?
We are the church.
So that was what he was speaking prophetically. The Lord shall send the rod of thy strength, says, out of Zion. Out of where?
Zion.
So God is not going to exercise authority for the Christian on this earth.
Yes,
it is the Christian that is going to do what? Exercise the authority or the lordship of Christ on this earth.
Hallelujah.
Glory. Come on, shout glory.
Glory.
How have you just caught what I just said?
Yes, sir.
So I am ruling in the midst of the enemies of Christ and the church. That means that even we'll get into that. Jesus conquered his enemies. Some of the enemies had not yet been destroyed. Amen.
Amen.
So he is still ruling. And they've all been made his footstool. And he's still ruling. But you see, on this earth, he is only ruling through his church.
Hallelujah.
So the lordship of Jesus is exercised through his church.
Hallelujah.
Without the church, he cannot exercise his lordship. Have you heard what I just said? And that is how extraordinary we are. So what we are expecting Christ to rule over, Christ has given us the right, the privilege to rule over it on this earth in his behalf or in his stead. So the question is, what are you ruling over now? And we'll get into that. Amen.
Amen.
You can rule over anything. Is that true?
It's true,
so that is what he's talking about in Psalm 110, verse 2. Then in the Acts chapter 2, verse 37, it tells us that now because of his crucifixion, God has made him what? Lord and Christ. Come on, shout, powerful.
Powerful.
See, after Jesus received the Holy Spirit and began to perform miracles and began to cast out devils and all that, that was not all. He made a very important statement that I want us to go to Luke chapter 11. Because he knew that for him to be Lord of all, for him to be made Lord, say made Lord.
Made Lord.
It's a making.
Yeah, it's a making, sir.
He was made. It wasn't just a title that was conferred on him. He needed to be made. Do you know what I just said?
Yes, sir.
So he said, he made him Lord. He did what?
He made him
Lord and Christ. So, when Jesus was walking on this earth, he made a very powerful statement before his death. Oh, shout glory.
Glory.
Luke chapter 11, verse 22. Oh, shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Can you start from verse 20? This is powerful. Say it's powerful.
It's
Say, I'm not an ordinary person. In the name of Jesus. In Christ Jesus, I'm not ordinary.
Pastor Prince will be right back.
Let your glory fill this house. Let your praises fill our mouth. Let each vessel offer up to you a sacrifice of praise. Are holy, and you alone are worthy. You deserve the glory, Jesus, you alone.
Gada 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 gada, receive that glory. Receive that glory. I see the power of God. I see the power of God.
I just held where the bullets went, and I said, I am bulletproof.
They put my name in a national newspaper in Portugal.
So after Papa prayed for me, I got a response for one, and then they gave me the PhD scholarship. They will pay my tuition, which about £17,000 sterling, a lot of money, and they were giving me stipend.
Lord, you alone are worthy. You deserve the glory, but Jesus, Jesus.
Experience the moments.
Welcome back.
It says, but if I, with the finger of God, that is the hand of God, that is the power of God. It says, if I, with the power of God, cast out devils. He did not say, if I, with the power of God, heal the sick. There is a reason. Because no one was casting out devils in the Old Testament. Hallelujah. If I, with the finger of God, cast out devils, it says, no doubt the kingdom of God is come upon you. Verse 21. Maladosh. Say maladosh. Then it says, when a strong man, armed. Somebody should check the Amplified or NIV for me. When a strong man armed, keep at his palace, his goods are in peace. He says, when a, this is one scripture that has been misinterpreted. Is that true?
Yes, sir.
Shout glory.
Glory.
I feel like turning some water into wine. Wherever you are watching me from, the power of God is coming to your home. Amen.
Amen.
When the word of God is coming, the strength of the spirit is coming.
Hallelujah.
Do you hear what I just said?
Yes.
No matter how weak you are, when the word of God comes, when you hear the voice of God, when you hear the word of God, you are strengthened.
Hallelujah.
Did you hear what I just said?
Yes, sir.
You don't understand what I just said. Yes. But it says, when one stronger than he. No, go to verse 21. You just give me the King James for the meantime. Let me deal with King James. It says, but when a strong man armed, keep his palace, his goods are in peace. When a strong man armed, keeps his palace, his goods are in peace. So when it says, when a strong man who is armed, amen, he's a strong man, and then he is armed. It says, if he keeps his palace, or he keeps his home, or he keeps his house, he's the keeper of his house, and he's a strong man. Do you understand? And he's armed. It says, his goose are in peace. Is that what he said? It means his goods are kept. Who has another translation for that? NIV or Amplified?
Amplified
says what?
When a strong man,
fully armed,
guards his own house,
his belongings
are undisturbed.
His belongings, his possessions are undisturbed.
And secured.
And secured. So when a strong man that is fully armed guards his house, what happens? His possessions, his belongings are secured.
Undisturbed.
Undisturbed. That is verse 21. Say a strong man.
A strong man.
Say a strong man.
A strong man.
Armed.
Armed.
Then he says, verse 22. Then he says, but when a stronger than he shall come upon him and overcome him, he taketh from him all his armor, his arms, wherein he trusted, and divide his spoils. Is that not powerful? Who has another amplified, another translation?
It says, but when someone stronger than he attacks and overpowers him, he robs him of all his armor.
But when someone who is stronger than the strong man, so the first person is a stronger man. It's a strong man. Then the second one is a stronger man. There is the first one that is the strong man armed with his possessions. He said what? His possessions. But when a stronger than he shall come upon him, that means that when a stronger person comes upon the strong man and overcomes that strong man or overpowers that strong man, he takes his armor and then he takes his goods. He breaks into the home. Then he takes his goods. Then he divides the spoil.
Yes, sir.
Is that what Jesus said?
Yes, sir.
Shout glory.
Glory.
This scripture is a turning point.
Hallelujah.
This scripture. This scripture is a pivotal scripture. It's a scripture that when you understand. See, many have misinterpreted this scripture. And they've turned it into prayer points. Every strong man in your house. Every strong man in your house. Amen.
Amen.
Jesus meant that there was a strong man in his house. That strong man was referring to was Satan, the devil. He was a strong man. Jesus called him a strong man. Armed with his goods. What are those goods? He had taken over the material world. He had authority. He was ruling over the world. That is why he said that all these things belong to me. If you worship, I will deliver it into your hands. Is that what he said? So he's armed with his goods. Then he says, but when a stronger than him, what is a stronger than him? Jesus is the stronger man. Then he says, when a stronger man goes to the strong man's territory, he disarms the strong man. He does what?
He disarms the strong
man. And takes his possessions and divides those possessions. So he was talking about what he was going to do. He was speaking when he had not yet died. Because he had not yet gone to defeat the devil. So he was speaking concerning that. Concerning the fact that he was going to go to the devil's territory. He was going to disarm the devil. He was going to take his goods. He was going to come out alive. Did you hear that?
Yes, sir.
So when you understand this scripture, it means that now it has been fulfilled. But he was speaking before it was fulfilled. And that's how we have it in the Gospel of Luke, the account of Luke. Did you hear what I just said?
Yes, sir.
So who is the stronger man? Jesus. Who is the strong man? The devil. Come on, shout glory.
Glory.
Where do you belong? Where do you belong?
I'm the stronger man, sir.
But it's important you understand this truth before I teach you what I want to teach you. Say, teach us, man of God.
Teach us, sir.
Don't forget this scripture.
Okay.
When you know you belong to the stronger man.
I belong to the stronger man.
And when you know that the stronger man has defeated the strong man, which we are going into right now, concerning his lordship. Come on, shout powerful.
Powerful.
Romans chapter 10. Say, I'm not an ordinary person.
I am not an ordinary person.
I am in the Lordship of Jesus.
I am in the Lordship of Jesus.
And because of that, I am Lord of all.
And because of that, I am Lord of all.
How many of you are following what I'm teaching?
Yes, Pastor.
Are you hearing something?
Yes, sir.
We are giving you something. We want you to hear something to practice. Did you hear what I just said?
Yes, sir.
No medical doctor give you a medicine to put on the table. Did you hear what I just said?
Yes,
come on, shout glory.
Glory.
We are training you to rule.
Glory.
Say, I'm receiving that training. Romans chapter 10, from verse 6.
Hello, my name is Walashi Tete. I work with the trust. I was invited to the World Changers Nation in 2018 September by Pastor Obed Jan. Prior to the time I joined the ministry, I was not planted in any particular church. My life was overwhelmed with many challenges which drove me to question myself if life was worth living. My first encounter with the man of God, Pastor Prince Ahinsa, was an unforgettable experience. He gave me a narrative prophecy of what was going on in my life, and the prophecy was so accurate, I couldn't help but sob uncontrollably. He also gave me a word that he sees me in a new car, which has come to pass. Through the teachings of the man of God, Pastor Prince, I have come to understand how to put the word of God to work in my life. I am now stable in the ministry and the things of God. I'm even serving in the outreach department. My prayer life has been touched in a special way, and I'm proud to share my faith with others. I would like to invite you all to fellowship with us at Airport West Hotel, 9 a.m. to 12, and also to watch our man of God, Pastor Prince, on Joy Prime, 7:30 a.m. every Sunday, as he brings to you changing your world. I have witnessed life-changing testimonies, and I'm confident your testimony is assured when you join us. Finally, I would want to thank the Lord Jesus for his special grace and his mercy towards me, and I would especially like to thank the man of God, Pastor Prince Ahinsa, for building me up in the word, and Pastor Mrs. Mabel Ahinsa, and all the pastors in the ministry for their love. I appreciate and thank all the partners of the ministry for the commitment they have shown to this heavenly vision. Glory!
Hello! Welcome to Changing Your World with Pastor Prince. Jesus is the same yesterday, today, and forever. It's a blessing to come your way this time. You see, the scripture says in 1 Timothy chapter 2, verse 4, it is who will have all men to be saved and to come to the knowledge of the truth. It says God wants all men, not some men. All men, including you that are not born, you are not born again, I'm speaking to you. He wants all men to be saved. Why? Because until you are saved, you are still under the dominion of darkness. You are still under the dominion of the devil. You are identified with him and his nature of sin. You cannot stop sinning unless you are born again. That's what Jesus said, you must be born again. So God wants all men to be saved. When you are saved, you are identified with the Lordship of Jesus. When you are saved, you are planted, placed in the kingdom of his dear son. You are placed in Christ Jesus. And it's a great privilege to have an association with the Lord Jesus. So if you are not yet born again, this is an opportunity for you to be born again. Confess this after me. Say, Lord Jesus, I believe you were raised from the dead by the glory of the Father. I confess you as my Lord and Savior. Thank you for coming into my heart. Amen.
Get more messages of Pastor Prince
on our social media handles. You are blessed.